High winds and waves on Toronto's waters have led to flooding on parts of the island, with the city warning residents that sandbag walls have been breached on the north shore. The situation being closely monitored as lake levels are still rising. Good evening. The city says some homes on the islands are surrounded by water this evening, but crews have been sent out to affected areas to begin pumping the water back into the lake. We spoke with a nervous resident earlier today who said once the winds hit, it took mere minutes for the water to breach the walls.
The berm dissolved and the sand and water washed across the street and up our sidewalk and eventually surrounded our house with about four other neighbors as well, and proceeded to roll down the street.
The city says the sandbagging breach was primarily on the downtown facing side of the islands, where beach chairs and benches were underwater. And Doreen Pieces Street, Seneca Avenue saw about 5 to 20 centimeters of water on their roads and to the homes.
It all happened so quickly that I didn't know what to do, and I didn't know how to cope with this kind of very quick emergency, because in 5 minutes, we had gone from a dry sidewalk to 2.5 or 2 feet of water in the sidewalk in front of our house. We tried to sandbag about five or six sandbags high to stop the waves from coming over. And after about an hour and a half, we partially succeeded in doing that.
It's unclear at this point how much damage was caused today, with the city saying crews will need about 72 hours to pump the water back out into the lake. They added re-sandbagging efforts are underway. As for Doreen Peace, she's wondering why the pumps near her home weren't functioning as islanders brace themselves for what Mother Nature will serve in the coming days.
Also, the city had put in two very large gas pumps, and unfortunately at the time that the wind came up, the pumps were off. I don't know the reason for that, but if it remains windy, we're going to be inundated again, because there is no way that two pumps can cope with the kind of water that's washed over this break wall.
And a city rep tweeted out today that pumps will be strategically placed in flooded areas to help with the clearing up the water the next few days. At this moment, the city says the island remains open and there's no need to evacuate.